Greetings from Kyiv, from Ukrainian pacifist movement. We are sole civil society organization in Ukraine calling for ceasefire and peace talks, criticizing weapon supplies and plans to wage defensive war forever. We are not Putin's agents, as you could hear in Ukrainian media. This old lie that pacifists are traitors is unfortunately persistent, while in reality, of course, we are agents of sheer common sense. We act for peace on all sides of conflicts, and of course, we strongly condemn Putin's wars of aggression against Ukraine with all death and destruction it brought. Under Russian shelling in Kyiv, here I personally sent a lot of public messages calling to peace talks instead of the obscene killing. What distinguishes us is that we condemn also war crimes and unwilling to negotiate peace on both sides. Military tactics which endangers and hurts civilians, mistreatment of prisoners of war, cruel conscription turning people into cannon fodder against their will, and these things nobody dare to criticize on our side, though loudly criticize on other side. We refuse to believe that violence could bring peace. Instead, we believe that only non-violent resistance, unarmed civil protection, development of peaceful economy, politics and culture give hope for peaceful future and abolition of war. My country today is hostile place for peace movements, unless of course you pretend to be peace movement while supporting army, calling for victory and destruction of enemy. There is a lot of activists in Ukraine who exploit international solidarity for the benefit of war effort, who even pretend to be proponents of nonviolence, peculiar sort of nonviolent hatred and nonviolent support of mass murder. And this is what encouraged by the state and by the armed forces. We are not such sort of hypocrites, but a small group of people trying to be consistent pacifists, despite all odds, to resist nonviolently all militarism and all war, to perform the threefold mission: uphold human right to refuse to kill, advocate ceasefire and peace talks in Ukrainian war and in all other wars in current sadly polarized and militarized world. Also, we build peace by truth telling, education, facilitation of dialogues and help to the needy. We are advocating human right to conscientious objection to military service, which is social taboo in Ukraine. Ukrainian army refuses to recognize this human right universally recognized in all civilized countries. We help to a prisoner of conscience Vitaly Alexeyenko, sentenced for 1 year of prison after his refusal to serve in army on religious grounds. And in result of our efforts, Supreme Court will review his case, despite he is already jailed in a correctional colony. And several other conscientious objectors are close to this dangerous situation. One of them risks to be sentenced for 3 years. One conscripted against his will and denied in request of discharge on the grounds of conscience. He is on front line in trenches. In cooperation with several international organizations, we support the Object War campaign, calling for asylum in European countries to conscientious objectors and deserters from Ukraine, Russia and Belarus. Also, we are protesting against prohibition to all men from traveling abroad, imposed to enforce military mobilization, because this prohibition violates human rights, creates corruption schemes, allowing rich men to leave Ukraine for big bribes, and causes tragedies when people, like students of European universities, who prefer education to dying in trenches, to kill themselves in desperate attempts to cross the border illegally, freezing to death in Carpathian Mountains, drowning in Tisa River. We are building peace, and our main way is truth telling. since many humanitarian initiatives are focused on support of civilians while maintaining social cohesion around war effort, our peace-building work is focused on support of anti-war activism and attempts to spread critical message about dangers of militarism. I will give you one recent example. We exposed a newly appointed Minister of Education and Science of Ukraine, Oksan Lisovyi, in plagiarism and militarism. We proved that almost half of this person's PhD dissertation is stolen, copy-pasted without giving credit to authors. And many media, including TV, who ignored the existence of pacifists for years, now reported about our whistleblowing. They even reported that we called to end the war by peaceful means and advocate the right to refuse to kill. Some publicity to pacifism, unexpected. A part of that, results were humble. The minister promised to surrender PhD degree, not even resign, if the state experts will confirm the fact of plagiarism. Problem is that propaganda favors and make people be proud of his public image of soldier and open promises to militarize education, to teach children to live with endless war and engage them into support of war effort, to improve shooting skills of kids in schools. Still, we continue to criticize him, and we informed UNESCO about militarist activities of Junior Academy of Sciences of Ukraine under his directorship during previous 10 years. UNESCO is supposed to build peace in minds, and I hope someone there will react on information that scientific center under auspices of UNESCO teach children to wage war and war for military industrial complex instead of building peace in minds. All we are doing is a hard work, harder than you could imagine, because, as I said, Ukraine is a hostile place for peace movements. People feel pressure when became visible in our peace movement. Some of them leave because of this pressure. Some tried to create splitter group, basically agreeing to messages of war propaganda, except of disagreement with human rights abuses related to mobilization, to conscription. And even this approach is perceived too radical, so they are reluctant to do anything meaningful except of self-advertising. Our appeals to Ukrainian society are mostly in vain and received with distrust and hatred, because propaganda associate pro-peace people with enemy, and vast majority believe to propaganda. They are victims of manufactured consent to war. Even those who want peace tend to trust messages of propaganda, if not Ukrainian, then Russian, while both are deceptive and warmongering. In lack of alternatives, practical knowledge and reliable information on peace, we must bring this peace education and peace journalism, this practical knowledge and reliable information. We lack of peace institutions, we lack of competent and committed people, and sometimes it is so sadly evident that I feel I am alone in peace efforts. But I remind myself, I must preserve and inspire hope. I believe that every person deep in heart and mind wishes peace despite all unfortunate trust to poisonous pro-war social contract. And I continue to work for peace by peaceful means, to build these institutions we lack, to educate this consistent pacifists we lack, trying to engage more people into genuine peace activities, sometimes a bit succeeding, and in these rare moments I have a feeling of a little miracle. International solidarity also helps to feel not alone. It is wonderful that I could contribute to peace rallies in United States and Europe, in Germany, Italy, United Kingdom, with a message of peace from Ukraine. I know that peace movements have hardships everywhere in the world, but we still are visible, loud, and dedicated to peace work. Militarist dictate and deception could not last long. sooner or later, common sense will prevail, and we will build better world without wars and without violent governance. Let's build lasting peace together.